Hi, my name is Katerina. I just started my postdoc a month ago in Lars's lab, and this is the project we are proposing for this hackathon in collaboration with Sampo Piuso from Finland. So, in previous years, our lab has developed a tagging engine that actually serves as the core of a dictionary-based named entity recognition system. And this system is used to solve a lot of biomedical problems. And actually, in combination with several dictionaries, it can be used to identify specific entities like cellular components, genes, proteins, and all the entities I'm showing here, and then find the relationships between those entities. And afterwards, all these are turned to specific identifiers from databases that are dedicated to them. And they are all available through many resources, like the ones shown in this network. All this data, of course, are available through RESTful APIs, and they all support the Open Annotation JSON-LD standard. The main pro of this system is that it is fast. So it can process actually many PubMed abstracts, thousands of them in a second. So we have one thing, which is the high speed, but what else do we need for a good system? This can be used to do both named entity recognition in massive text corpora, like what I said before, but it's also being used in real-time text mining. So apart from its speed, we need good recall, and in order to get good recall, we need comprehensive dictionaries for each of the entities that we're trying to recognize, but also we need good precision. And how would we get that? For that, we actually need blacklists. But the problem with the blacklists at this time is that they are manually curated. What does this mean? It means that actually we go through the most frequent terms in a corpus, and we identify those that we go through them, and we identify those that shouldn't be there, and they are not actually entities that should be tagged, and we put them in a blacklist. But of course, since this involves manual curation, it can only scale that much. It cannot go very far. So what we're proposing is actually to use deep learning to improve this blacklisting. And what we will do is, what we want to do is to extend the blacklist automatically by actually using the context around the words. So what do we need for that? We need positive and negative training examples. And where do we find those? Our idea for now is to use three named entity recognition systems, actually what is used now in String, PubDator, and EVEX. And from the results, we will have tens of millions of text spans on which the systems agree or disagree. So after that, if we have these results, we can create positive and negative examples of contexts around these entities. But of course, this is our first idea for this project, so if you have any other ideas for how we can create actually the training datasets, which is a very basic part of our work, you're very welcome to communicate those. And after we have this textual context, we will train a state-of-the-art domain-specific deep learning model, and based on recent literature, what we actually plan to use for now is BERT, and specifically BioBERT. So we will have a ranked list of the most problematic names. And what we will do after we get that list back from the model is to evaluate its quality. After evaluation, we will see if it can be used as is by the NERSC system that we have, or if it can guide the manual curation effort. We aim for the first. After we do the evaluation, we hope that the results are very good, and in the future we will be able to incorporate it automatically. But if not, at least it can always help us to guide the manual curation. Then, after we have the new blacklist, we will be able to directly incorporate it into the aforementioned tagger that I said before, and without actually affecting its speed in any way. And since the results and the tagger is available through RESTful APIs, all the results that we will get will be also immediately publicly available. We really hope that this will lead in precision improvement through the improvement of the blacklist, and of course the enhancement of many biomedical dictionaries. Thank you for your attention.